Would you please welcome Jack River? Hey, great to see you. I think it's worth demonstrating for everyone watching at home just how rock star your life has become, because you posted your schedule on Instagram. Here it is. Wake up. Because you've just become a mum. It's pretty full-on by the looks of
it. It is pretty full-on. Being a mum is like a full-time rock star job. By 9 a.m. you seem to have done a million things. So I feel like touring was a really good, you know, preparation for motherhood. Yeah.
You seem like you're nailing it. You're here in white.
Thank you.
You know, as a new mum, and your baby's out the back with Billy Ocean right now, is that right?
Yeah, she's charming Billy Ocean somewhere out the back.
Now, I hear that you're in a big group chat of mums in the music industry on WhatsApp. What sort of stuff do you chat about?
Well, taking a baby to an airport is a whole shebang. Yeah. Normal mums groups kind of think, you know, oh, I might do that at like 8 months or something, but we've had to, you know, tour with babies very early on in the piece. So, yeah, we talk about touring babies, all the weird tips and tricks to take a baby on the road.
Presumably you put them in the overhead compartment, right?
What's a good tip?
Oh, my gosh, what is a good tip? The one that's coming to mind is from KLP, Christy Lee Peters. Mm. Shout out to her, amazing woman. She takes a piece of black fabric everywhere she goes, so she can black out any surface that's causing an issue.
Ah, that's a good one.
What about the big earmuffs for side of stage for a baby? That seems so important.
Yes, Maggie has earmuffs.
Yeah.
She hasn't worn them just yet. She's getting ready for Splendor in the Grass.
Oh, so, great. Yeah. I'll see her there in the pit, dancing away with the muffs. Now, I want to talk about your new album. You've described it as an apocalyptic daydream, which is, I guess, a normal thing to kind of have a theme for an album. Are you a doomsday? Have you built like a bunker that you're going to bury yourself in when it all goes tits up?
I do enjoy a bit of doomsday preparation and thinking through the apocalypse right to the end, so I just thought I'd make the soundtrack for it. But no, I guess I naturally make very fun, sparkly pop, but I wanted to give a bit of a nod to the real life situation happening outside of music.
Yeah.
So yeah, my album's called Endless Summer, and it does sound like a beautiful endless summer, but meanwhile there is, you know, really real stuff going on outside of music land, so I wanted to speak to that.
Well, for a musician, what is the biggest threat? Is it climate change or AI? Because we're hearing that AI is taking jobs away from musicians. Are you worried about AI as well?
Hopefully the climate change melts the AI situation.
That would be great. Yeah.
No, but I think AI would be the darkest threat in the picture.
Yeah.
Yeah. But hopefully the sun melts them all. Yeah. Someone melts their
servers. Well, robots feel the heat as well. You know, they overheat regularly.
They do.
But they've got weapons.
Oh, I forget about
that. The drones with the...
Yeah.
I feel like the robot.
But a big solar ray, we just need to pray that the sun's going to destroy everything at some point. The solar storms, guys. Rely on them.
We're at the other side of COVID. How hard was it for Australian musicians during that dark two-year period and since?
It was really hard, to be honest. A lot of music businesses and artists suffered around an 80% downturn in their businesses.
Wow.
And we're still, you know, we are entertainers, like the show must go on, and we want to act like everything's okay, but it really is still quite a tough time because people's ticket buying behaviours have changed and there's a real influx of shows in the marketplace, so we're still dealing with a lot behind the scenes.
So what's next for you? You're hitting the festival circuit, you're taking baby Maggie with you.
I am, yeah. I'm taking it to Splendor. I'm thinking of doing like a Simba moment in front of the crowd. I just got to talk to a child psychologist first to make sure it's okay. But yeah, taking her on the road to see, to do a number of festivals this year and continuing to make music.
There you go, Sam. Someone who vomits more than you at a festival.
Oh, here we go. I mean, yeah, well, she's probably on my intellectual level at a festival, so I think we can... maybe I'll hang out with baby Maggie at
Splendor. She's pretty smart. You guys could hang out.
Oh, great. Yeah, I'll come and find her at Splendor.
Have you got a sparkly onesie?
I've got multiple. Yeah,
okay.
So, yeah.
All right, great.
We can colour code each day.
Okay, sounds good.
Very irresponsible babysitter. Sorry about that. Jack River's new album, Endless Summer, is out now. Would you please thank the wonderful Jack River?
Yeah.